Сегодня главная новость для всех мировых СМИ – регистрация России первой вакцины от коронавируса. И как и 60 с лишним лет назад, в заголовках опять русское слово «спутник». Именно так называется препарат, появление которого должно стать переломным моментом в борьбе с пандемией.
Hello, Blazers! It is your boy Roman, your favorite neighborhood Russian. Hi, guys, doing today? Welcome to a brand new video. In today's video, guys, we're gonna be talking about something that was very highly requested on my channel. I've been getting DMs and requests about this for all the time for the past, like, 3 days. Today, we're finally talking about the news that actually Vladimir Putin broke himself recently. The fact that Russia apparently has created the first COVID-19 vaccine in the world. Pretty unexpected, huh? The new vaccine that is literally entitled Sputnik V, or Sputnik 5, I guess. It sounds very promising on paper, however, it has not really been tested properly yet, and also the entire world health and science community is very, very skeptical of it. So let's talk about it. However, before we really get into this, I want you guys to just understand where I'm coming from, okay? It is very much popular within, like, people who are oppositional to the Russian government, to people who don't like Putin and stuff like that, to just basically not only try to criticize Russia for its negative doings, but also to basically criticize Russia and make fun of it for anything. Even if there's some positive developments that people are trying to do, people are always like, oh, it's this goddamn Rashka. Yeah, we can't produce anything. We're just a stupid country full of stupid people with stupid politicians. Russia doesn't know how to do anything but sell oil and gas and create Kalashnikovs and vodka, you know, stuff like that. I want you to understand that that is not where I'm coming from. I am coming from a point of view of healthy skepticism, not from the point of view of we can't do anything because Russia sucks kind of narrative. In this video, I just want to look at what's going on, what the vaccine is all about, what is actually going to happen, and also what does this mean and what does the world community think about it. Not from a point of view of haha, Ruski vodka, Kalashnikov, you know what I mean. Now before we really get into it, I would like to take a minute and thank the sponsor of today's video, Surfshark VPN. In our current tumultuous times, things like privacy and security of our internet usage are very much at risk. And not only those things, but also the access to internet itself and free speech on the internet sometimes are also targeted. For example, just look at what's going on in Belarus right now, just what I was talking about in the last video. They've had no internet for like the past 4 days because the government decided to just shut it down. And to be honest, these days, if you live in a Western democracy, you never know if one day you're gonna end up like Belarus. Perhaps this is why I think that having a good VPN to secure your access to the internet and also secure your privacy in your security is one of the most important things right now. Surfshark is honestly the best VPN service I've ever used. I've been using it for a few months now. It is a VPN that protects your online data and also allows you to use websites that you otherwise maybe could have not been able to use. Surfshark has a lot of great features. For me, the most beneficial are, for example, the ability to use it on an unlimited amount of devices. And also, I personally love the feature of camouflage mode that allows you to basically stay undetected and for your provider to be completely unaware of you having a VPN, and it works great. And you can use Surfshark for simpler things as well, for example, changing your location and being able to go on Canadian or American Netflix. So if you want to get yourself a good VPN, then go over to surfshark.deal/nfkrz and use code nfkrz to get 85% off of a 2-year plan and 3 extra months for free. With Surfshark, you can ensure your internet security, internet freedom, and internet privacy. And also, by getting it, you support your boy. So yeah, once again, if you care about being free online and stuff, then go over to surfshark.deal/nfkrz and enter code NFKRZ at checkout and make sure you're ready for anything they might throw at you. Once again, big thank you to Surfshark for sponsoring this video, and let's get into it. The Russian coronavirus vaccine in Christen, Sputnik V or Sputnik 5, I don't know, honestly, has been revealed or announced on August 11th. The vaccine actually has its own official website that you can check out, and this is not an advertisement or anything, but they should pay me definitely for this. Now guys, as far as what the vaccine does, I mean, I could be sitting here for 10 minutes trying to explain it, but honestly guys, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a medic, I'm not here to talk about this particular way it works. Yeah, I did not sign up for this. The website is actually in English, so you can go and read about it. The vaccine was created by the Gamaleya National Center of Epidemiology and Microbiology. The first time the vaccine was ever mentioned was during a teleconference between Vladimir Putin and the Russian Minister of Health. And here's what they had to say.
Насколько мне известно, сегодня утром впервые в мире зарегистрирована вакцина против новой коронавирусной инфекции. Я в этой связи хочу попросить министра здравоохранения Мурашко Михаила Альбертовича проинформировать нас поподробнее, хотя знаю, что она работает достаточно эффективно, формирует иммунитет устойчивый. Повторяю, прошла все необходимые проверки. Я это тоже хорошо очень знаю, поскольку одна из моих дочерей сделала себе такую прививку. Думаю, что в этом смысле она поучаствовала в эксперименте. После первого укола, после первой прививки температура была у нее 38, на следующий день 37 с небольшим, и все. После второго укола, второй прививки тоже температура немного поднялась. Ну и все, сошло потом на нет. Чувствует себя хорошо.
So according to Putin, the vaccine has gone through all the necessary checks, and also his own daughter, not specified which, he never talks about his daughters really, and they're not public figures, has actually volunteered and taken a shot of the new vaccine, and is feeling fine, and is doing great. You know, I guess it's debatable how ethical it is for a head of a country to have his children as volunteers, but honestly, if that's true, because I mean, we can't know, and Putin has my respect, because I mean, if you want to push this idea that the vaccine is fully ready and it's fully operational and it's safe, then why not, like, you know, let your children use it? I mean, that shows that you know it's safe, right? Because these are your children. These are the people you care about the most. What's also been said is that Russia is basically going to be able to mass produce the vaccine, and the plans are for the vaccine to be fully implemented around the entirety of the country and put into circulation amongst the general population around January 1st, 2021. So by the start of the next year, essentially, they're going to be rolling out the vaccine to the entirety of the country. So let's talk about it. How tested is this vaccine actually? There are a few issues with it that I feel, I mean, this is not the end of the world or anything, but I do feel like they're jumping the gun a little quick here. Again, I'm not a doctor, but just looking at what the media says and what a lot of people in the health industry say, it seems like they are jumping the gun a little too quick here. So here's the thing. Putin and Russia have essentially announced that we have created the first coronavirus vaccine in the world. We're the best. We're the best music, DJ Khaled. And that essentially we're doing a better job than anybody else in the world, which is actually not true. Russia is in phase one of the creation of the coronavirus vaccine. So far, this new Sputnik vaccine has been distributed and tested on 38 patients. These patients are still under observation, and also the Gamaleya Institute, the creators of this vaccine, they have promised but did not publish the details of this vaccine trials in any scientific journals. A lot of other research institutions that are developing the coronavirus vaccine right now have published their results. Again, I want to give them the benefit of the doubt because they've said that actually will publish them later this month, so we're waiting for that. So being in phase one, as far as I understand, basically means that the Russian Institute has basically ran one round of tests. When a vaccine is usually developed, it comes in three stages, three phases, and each phase represents a new round of testing. So the first stage is for evaluating the drug's safety. The second is the study of immunogenicity, so basically how much the dosage of it should be. And phase three is when the vaccine is compared to a placebo, so it establishes the effectiveness of the vaccine. Essentially, a lot of Western institutes that are working on their version of the coronavirus vaccine have already started phase 3 tests, while Russia is in phase 1. A lot of these institutions in the West have already run tests on hundreds of patients, while Russia is less than 100 people in. This does not undermine the great work that our scientists are doing. The thing is just that this vaccine is practically not yet ready, and our governments is saying that it is. Meanwhile, in the West, they've actually gone way further than us in developing the vaccine, and they're still not ready to say that it's ready yet. Because with things like these, a lot of lives are at stake, and a lot of people's health is at stake, and you cannot just jump the gun and, you know, say that we have the first vaccine in the world, I don't know, to get some points, I guess. Honestly, right now it feels like as if we're in the Cold War period or something, you know what I mean? I mean, I was just looking at the news, for example, right, and the way everything is portrayed, I mean, it's very optimistic, it's very uplifting to watch, but also, I mean, it's kind of strange, and it's way too optimistic, I would say.
Вы можем себя чувствовать уверенно, защищённым?
Да, можете чувствовать уверенно, защищённым, безусловно, да.
В критический момент, когда пандемия нарастала, учёным надо было реагировать быстро и найти способ защитить людей от смертельного вируса. С этой задачей они справились.
I mean, the news are literally acting as if the coronavirus vaccine is ready, and like, that's it. What I'm just trying to say is that the way it's all presented, it feels like it's almost in a sort of, it's like this gesture to show like, hey, we showed the West, we created the coronavirus vaccine faster. It's not really about who created the first, it's about who created the best. It's about creating the best vaccine as a human collective, okay? For the scientists of the world to unite. And I mean, they're talking about that. Of course, it's not like there's no communication or partnership with the Western and Russian institutes about this, but just the way it's presented, it honestly feels like it's like a Cold War. It's like an arms race about who gets to create the coronavirus vaccine first, whether it's the West or it's Russia. And I just don't like the sentiments. We're not in an arms race, okay? We need to collaborate. We need to work together. It's not about us creating the first vaccine and it doesn't matter how safe it is and how tested it is. Again, I'm all for supporting Russian medicine and Russian science, and I believe in our people because Russians are smart, okay? Russians are smart fucking people. We've invented so much shit, honestly. So I am definitely giving the benefit of the doubt, and I do believe that our scientists know what they're doing. I'm just saying that when politics come into play, And when the entire thing is shown as an arms race, that's where we have a problem. It doesn't need to be like that. As far as I understand from the analysis of the situation in the media, also what this means is that essentially the Russian Ministry of Health has already, they consider this vaccine as a working and safe vaccine, even though it's not fully tested yet. It's not like the Russian Ministry of Health just said, okay, this is a great development, we're gonna provide you all this financial aid, all this support that you need to work on it and to perfect it. No, essentially what they did is that they said, okay, there you go guys, the vaccine is done. We're registering this as the official vaccine and we're gonna be rolling it out on January. I mean, this of course would also provide more financial help for the researchers and stuff like that, but recognizing a vaccine that is not ready as something that is gonna be distributed to around the entire country, it's a bit problematic. And also a big problem with it is that what this essentially means is that now this vaccine could be tested on more people without their approval, essentially. So before they could literally only test volunteers. Now, however, though, the vaccine can be tested on people that cannot say no, essentially. For example, soldiers in the Russian army, maybe some health workers, I mean, other types of people who just can't say no because they work in a governmental organization. The vaccine is only in the first round of tests and you already are, you know, broadening the amount of people you could try it on. This actually could lead to some potential hazards and for the people, for the health of the people that's gonna be tested on, especially if those people are going to be basically, you know, tested involuntarily. I mean, again, I guess the more people, the more research they can do, but it's not the way to go about it. And so yeah, that is pretty much all that is known right now. I appreciate the fact that Russia is doing some strides in the development of the coronavirus vaccine, and I do not think that Russians are somehow worse at it. I do think that Russian medicine, Russian scientists are just as competent. What annoys me in particular is that politics come into play, and essentially it accelerates this process to an unhealthy degree. And obviously, guys, I'm a simpleton. I don't know anything about this stuff. I'm not a doctor. But I'm just hoping that the Russian scientists that are working on this take all the needed precautions, they act in good faith, and that our government also acts in good faith and does not just rush the creation and implementation of this vaccine to just own the West or whatever to show that, yeah, we can do it first. We did it first. We did it better. Ha! How about that? We did it better. It's not about being first. It's about being the best, okay? And we can be the best. And also, guys, I didn't know why I didn't talk about this sooner, but obviously I'm not an anti-vaxxer or anything like that. I do believe in the vaccines having benefits for your health. If the vaccine is going to be approved, if it's going to be definitely safe and it's going to be tested properly, there's going to be real results, I will get vaccinated. I don't have any issue with it. I'm not an anti-vaxxer or anything, okay? I just want to look at it from the healthy point of skepticism, and I want to know if something's safe before I have it injected inside of me, okay? So yeah, guys, I guess that is going to be pretty much it for today's video. I hope this video answers some of your questions about the Russian vaccine right now. Hopefully you understand the situation a little better. If you guys did enjoy this video, if you guys did find it entertaining, please make sure to slap the like on this video. Also, guys, if you want to support me, make sure to go over to the link down in the description to my Patreon, donate to it. I would gladly appreciate it. Helps me out a lot. Donate to me if you want to support my channel, support what I do, yada yada yada. Also buy my YouTubes, also links are all down in the description. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.